So now let's turn to the females. What do the females have to say? The whole perspective of female participation in sexual selection is viewed in terms of female choice. Females choose whether they're going to mate with one particular male peacock or another. And it turns out that all of that crazy behavior of the male is trying to inspire the female to mate with them. The males aren't just being mindless show-offs. They're giving the females a chance to choose. He's not going to coerce her. He's not going to manipulate her into mating with her. He just wants to inspire her to think that he's so sexy that she should have her babies with him. Now, this is the sort of thing that is found in all kinds of, particularly in bird species all around the world, lots of different insects. We even have quite a crazily colored bird here in Minnesota, the prairie chicken. There's a big statue to this in Rothsay, Minnesota, on the side of the highway. Here's real prairie chickens. And the male has this absurd bonnet that it grows during the breeding season with bright coloration. It has this bizarre posture, and it stomps its feet and makes silly noises. Okay? And all in that is to try to get a good impression, to make a good impression on this female so that she'll mate with him as opposed to somebody else. So the females in these situations shop around. Okay? They are free agents, and they can freely choose whichever male they like the most. The birds of paradise are the most extravagantly feathered and colored of any birds. They're quite common down in Papua New Guinea and in northern Australia. The males have exceptionally bright colors, ridiculous, extravagant kinds of feathers, all of which they show off to the rather drab female, trying to impress upon her to mate with him rather than that other guy. So this is the greater bird of paradise, same thing, the blue bird of paradise, where the male again has these crazy feathers, much more brightly colored than the female. Likewise with the king of Saxony bird of paradise, the very drab female on the right. Goldie's bird of paradise, female coming up to choose between these ridiculously colored and plumaged bird males. Red bird of paradise, all this crazy investment in feathers and in behavior to impress the female for mating. Wilson's bird of paradise, 12-wired bird of paradise, very drab females compared to these very colorful males. So the thing in common for these birds of paradise is that they are polygynous. You have one male who may mate with lots of different females, as opposed to monogamous, so that's one male with one female. With polygynous, one male with multiple females, that's where you get the most extraordinary coloration. So the monogamous males, the male actually is a good dad. He provides paternal care. And so he's not just there to look good, he actually helps around the house. But the polygynous males, all that happens there is they mate the females at the avian equivalent of a singles bar. They have their matings, and that's it. She'll never see him again. So the male has to make an impression. He has to really, really convince the female that I am the man of your dreams so that she mates with him as opposed to somebody else. And the fact is that females really do pay attention to these crazy, crazy differences in feathers and coloration. This is a classic study on an African bird called the long-tailed whydah. The bird is up here and its huge tail down here is so long that during the breeding season, when the tail is grown out like this, the male can barely fly. So a very cunning scientist did an experiment where he took a bunch of these birds and he got a scalpel and he chopped the feathers, okay, and cut out segments of the long tails of any certain individuals. And he might have glued the tips back on, and so he would have shortened some males, so they're missing their middle segments. But then he took those middle segments from one bird and did a transplant and gave these lucky guys even longer tails than they would have had otherwise. And he did a couple of controlled experiments where he chopped their tails and glued them back together just to see what would happen. And so what was quite clear is that the females actually did care about how long the male's tail was. And so the number of nests that were established within the territory of each one of these males was really a lot larger in the lucky recipients of those tail transplants whereas these guys who lost bits of their tails had smaller numbers of females coming to mate with them. So we see that males have incredibly impressive traits in a large number of species. We now also see that females do care about that, and they prefer to mate with the most impressive males.